Okay, let's work through these. Analyzing the intervals. All right. D up to A. First of all, it's some kind of fifth. 1, 3, 5, space, space, space. 1, 3, 5. It's a fifth. What's a perfect fifth from D on the key of D? F sharp, C sharp. Two sharps in the key of D. So A would, it would just be D to A. But this is a flat, so that makes it a diminished fifth. All right, B to F sharp. 1, 3, 5, it's some kind of fifth. In the key of B, what is a perfect fifth? Well, F sharp, oh, F sharp. So this is a perfect fifth. In the key of B, there's an F sharp. The F is an F sharp, so that's a perfect fifth. Because in the key of B, F sharp's the fifth note. It's a perfect fifth. All right. This is F sharp to C. Key signature is no sharps or flats, so F sharp to C. What's a perfect fifth in the key of F sharp, or the fifth in the perfect fifth interval? F sharp to C sharp. Accidentals are the same; they agree unless there's an F and a B, and that's an F and a C. So it's perfect fifth would be F sharp to C sharp, but that's not F sharp to C sharp. It's F sharp to C. This makes it a diminished fifth. Why? Because it should be an F sharp. I mean, it should be a C sharp, but it's a C natural, so it got, it was lowered a half step. So instead of being perfect, it's diminished. All right. F to D, F. So it's space, space, space. That's 1, 3, 5, and that's a sixth. That's a sixth note. So it's some kind of six. Interval of a six. Now, what's the quality of it? Well, in the key of F, what is a major six? I think you have one flat. Let's go one flat, B flat. Oh, okay. So F to D natural would be a major six. So this is a minor six. Right, let's do this one right here. And the bass clef. So, well, it's one, some kind of seven. So all the spaces are, you know, 1, 3, 5, 7. It's some kind of seventh. In the key of A, what's a major seventh? Well, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp. So A to G sharp's major, so this is A to G natural, makes this a minor. All right, this is what? E to A flat, E to A flat. Well, in the key of E, what's the fourth note? Well, let's see, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp. Oh, A. So E to A is a perfect fourth. This is E to A flat, makes it a diminished fourth. All right, D sharp to F sharp. Well, easiest way to do this, since there is no key of D sharp, is just take both those sharps off. Now, the same distance would be D to F. It's the same exact distance as D sharp to F sharp, D to F. So what is D to F? Well, the key of D, what's a major third? F sharp, see, well, it would be a F sharp. D to F sharp is a major third. So D to F, though, remember, we took both those sharps off, so now we can figure it a little bit easier. So D to F, well, it's a minor third. So is D sharp to F sharp, also a minor third. D to F, D sharp to F sharp, D to F, D flat to F flat. Those are all the same distance, the distance of a minor third. Because D to F sharp would be a major third. And D sharp to F double sharp would be a major third. That's ridiculous. All right, D to F flat. Oh, well, we've already established D. We talked about D. We took those flat, those sharps off. We said, okay, now it's D to F. Let's figure D to F. Well, so now I really do have a D to F. Well, D to F, we just already talked about that. D to F is a minor third. But this is D to F flat. D to F flat makes it a diminished third. Okay. All right, perfect fifth down from, we're in treble clef, perfect fifth down from C. Remember, if to figure out interval down, you have to go up the opposite, or and the numbers equal 9. So perfect fifth down is a perfect fourth up. So we're going to figure the perfect fourth up, and that'll give us the answer for the perfect fifth down. Now, this is, like I say, this is an easy one. You could do this one probably without thinking. But we want to go through the process because we want this to be a principle, an exercise, a procedure, better word, that you just do without thinking. That you're just so used to it. You're so you've gotten that habit of doing it. So a perfect fifth down is a perfect fifth, perfect fourth up. So 1, 2, 3, 4. It's an F something in the key of C. F is just F, so it's a perfect fourth. So the answer is F to C. Let's just check it now. In the key of F, is C the fifth note? Yes, it is. That is a perfect fifth. F to C is a perfect fifth. Accidentals agree. Unless it's an F and a B, then we have to kind of pause and pick it. But this is F to C. That's a perfect fifth. Accidentals agree. Now we go to a minor seventh down. Well, a minor seventh down, to find the answer at the bottom, we want to go up a major second. Down a minor seventh, I'm going to go up a major second. So what's up a major second from A flat? Well, it's going to be A flat, that's a black note, up to B flat. All right, that's a major second. So drop it back down to B flat. You want to put the accidental because there's no key signature, so we're having to add the accidentals here. All right, is that true in B flat? What is a minor seventh from B flat? Well, let's figure it. In the key of B flat, what does a major seventh look like? Well, it's B flat to A, right? So a minor seventh would be B flat to A flat. B flat to A is a major seventh because in the key of B flat, there are two flats, B flat and E flat. There's no A flat, it's A natural. So a major seventh from B flat is B flat to A natural. This is a B flat to A flat, it's a minor seventh. So that answer is correct. We want to go down to major sixth. So to go down a major sixth, we want to go up a, opposite of this, minor, and then subtract this from 9, and you get 3. So you want to go up a minor third. So you're going to go up a minor third. All right, we're going from E. So what's a minor third up from E? Well, it's going to be a G something because we're going up a third. In the key of E, what's a major third? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D. Oh, G sharp. So G sharp is major, so minor would just be G natural. We don't need to put an accidental because there's no key signature. So E to G is a minor third. So let's bring the G down. Now let's figure this out. A major six up from G. Well, in the key of G, there's only one sharp, F sharp. So that's correct. G to E is a major six. E is the sixth note in the G major scale. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G. So E is just the sixth note, so G to E is a major six. All right, we want to go down a minor third. Well, hey, we just talked about that. So it's going to be that, yeah? The opposite of minor is major. So we're going to go up a major sixth. Up a major sixth. All right, let's go up a major sixth from B. All right, 1, 3, 5, 6. So it's 1, 3, 5, line, 1, 3, 5, and then 6 is right here. It's a G something. All right, a major 6 up, B to F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp. Oh, G sharp. It's 5 sharps in the key of B, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. So that should be a G sharp. Wait, major 6. That's correct. So major 6 up makes it a down here, you put a major six, put a G sharp, I mean, and now you have the minor third. Is that right? G sharp to B? Well, there's no key to G sharp, but I can figure it this way by knocking off that sharp and adding a flat here, moving both down a half step, putting that down to G natural, making that a B flat, lower both of them down a half step, and I come to G to B flat. Well, that's definitely a minor third. So G sharp to B is a minor third. G to B flat is a minor third. G sharp to B is a minor third. Okay. Let's go to this one. Now that's a augmented sixth up. And we're in the key. So it's a B. It's a bass clef. So a B up an augmented sixth. Now it's like, wow. Inverting them is hard, and now you get just a regular one. It's like, okay, I can do this. 1, 3, 5, 6. So it's going to be a G something. B to G. In the key of B, what does a G look like in the key? In the B flat, in the B major scale, what is a G? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sh oh, G sharp. So a major six up from B is G sharp. So augment, it's going to be a double sharp. Yep, because B to G sharp is major. B to G double sharp is augmented. It's an augmented six. A plus minted. An augmented, a plus minted. A very tall six. Okay. All right, a minor six down. Minor six down. So what's a, if you flip a minor six the other direction, becomes a major third. All right, what's a major third up from G flat? So we're in the key, we're just pretend we're in the key of G flat. B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, C flat. Up a major third. What's going to be a B? So I just said it's the first accidental. B flat, E, oh, B flat. So that's the major third up. So bring it down here. G, is that B flat? So B flat's right here. All right, so the answer is B flat to G flat. B flat to G flat is a minor six. Was that right? Let's see. In the key of B flat, what's a major six? Key of B flat. Well, B flat, E flat. Just two flats, so G would be just a G. All right, so that's major. So yeah, minor. Minor is B flat to G flat. That's a minor six. All right, we're going on a major seventh from A. Well, what's a opposite of a major seventh? Is a minor second. So we want to go a minor second up. A minor second from A, it's going to be a B flat. Minor second. A to B flat. It's just half step. A to B flat. Let's bring it right down here. Put the B flat down here now. Right. A major seventh from B flat is A. B flat to A is a major seventh. A is the last note of a B flat major scale. B flat, E flat, it's just B flat to A. That's a major seventh. All right. Well, this one is D, right? We're in bass clef, so D. Up a perfect fifth. One, three, five. It's going to be a fifth. D to A. Yeah, D to A. Accidentals agree. These fourths and fifths, you have to really think through this key signature of the fourths and fifths. Just remember the accidentals are the same unless there's an F and a B. The accidentals agree unless there's an F and a B. Then you have to pause and make sure you're doing it right. But for the perfect fifths and perfect fourths, the accidentals are going to be the same for both notes. The only exception are the F and B or B to F. That's the only exceptions. All right, now let's look at these scales. Letter C. Now on the exam, I'm going to say, okay, I'm just I'll probably this will be on the exam. You'll already have the notes written for you, so you don't have to mess with it. I'm going to say place accidentals in front of the appropriate pitches in relationship to the given key signature. So we're in the key of A flat, so I say, okay, put all the flats in the key of A flat. All right. Now, to keep yourself from making really dumb mistakes, which I've already seen on some homework, people just anyway, make sure you do it in order. All right, so A flat is B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat. It's four flats. B flat, E flat, A flat, one more, D flat. So I'm going to put them in that order. B flat, E flat. Let's see, we're starting on this. There's A to A, all right. B flat, E flat, A flat. And since it's at the beginning note, on the last note, B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat. Can't believe I'm writing those as far away. I'm standing a long ways away. I'm way away from them. My arms barely because of this camera right here. This camera. Silly camera. All right. In the key of B, what are the accidentals of the key of B? Well, it's a sharp key, right? How many sharps? Five sharps. All right, so let's start. Let's do it. We're in treble clef still, so it's going to be F sharp. Gonna make sure you get that right, huh? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. Ta-da! All right, key of G flat. We're in bass clef. Gotta make sure you get that correct. Take your time. Okay, what key is it? Okay, which clef are we in? All right, so that's a G. So to be G flat, I'm gonna go ahead and put that G flat there. All right, we'll start. B flat. E flat. A flat. D flat. G flat. And I gotta go one more past the name. C flat. B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, C flat. So everybody's flat except for F. All right, and figured out the F sharp yet? How many sharps in the key of F sharp major? Six. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, E sharp. Let's put them in order. F sharp. And there's also an A sharp, F sharp here. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, E sharp. Yeah, the only note not sharped in the key of F sharp major is B. All right, let's go do letter D, rewrite the first melody in the new time signature. Write the rhythmic syllables underneath the given melody. All right, now we're in 3/16 time. Is this simple time or compound time? Well, simple, because anything with a 2, 3, or 4 at the top is simple time. It's simple time. If there's a 2, 3, or 4 at the top, it's simple time. Beat is evenly divided. So when you see a 2, 3, or 4 at the top, you're going to be counting that thing 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Or 1 and 2 and 3, and that's how you're going to count it. All right. So 1 and 2 and 3. All right. So we're in 3/16 time. Oh my goodness, that's one crazy composer. 2, 3. That's an eighth note, which is equal to 2/16. So that beats one and two right there. So I'll put one here, and then I'll put two in parentheses right here, and that's beat three. What? Why? Well, that's because there are three beats to the measure, and the 16th note gets the beat. So there are the equivalent of 3/16 notes in every measure. Well, there's 2/16, and there's a third. Look at this. These are 32nd notes. So that is 1/16 note equal to 1/16 note. So that's one and two and three. So one and two and three. It's tied over, so this is going to be one in parentheses. Oh, and these are 16ths. So two, three. That's going to be one. Two and that's still a six. That's a 32nd. Those are 32nds, and there's three. And then look at this. There's a 16th note, so that's one, and that's an eighth note, so that's two, and then three in parentheses. All right, now we're going to rewrite it in 3/4 time, where the quarter note gets the beat. Quarter note. Quarter note. One, two, three. Now you want to go on this thing right here. You should be by looking at just these, the syllables, the numbers underneath, be able to figure out this rhythm. All right, so that A, it's beats, it's two beats, so two beats, half note. That's beat three, so it's going to be a quarter note. Now notice I'm trying to get it right under the beats, right? All right, so that's one and. So in 3/4 time, one and looks like two eighth notes. One and is two eighth notes. So that's going to be. One and two and three. I'm not, we can't. I could actually put those together in 3/4 time, but I'm going to do on the beat, right? That's a little too low, but I'm not going to worry about it right now. Well, I guess I am going to worry about it. Practice what you preach, Mr. Dan. All right. One and two and three. It's got to tie over to this note, which is another eighth note. No, that's a quarter note. Amen. And there's one, two, and three. So that's quarter. Down here's gonna be a quarter note, two eighth notes, quarter note. That's an F sharp, and then E sharp, and then the G here, quarter note. So this is, you got beat, and then a note that goes, that's equal to two beats. So that would be a quarter note. And then a half note, and it's a D. All right, there is a transcription from 3/16 time to 3/4 time. Let's do this one now, 6/4 to 6/8. Now we're in compound. Anything with a 6, 9, or 12 at the top, you're going to count it. 1 lolly, 2 lolly, 1 lolly, 2 lolly, 1 lolly, 2 lolly, 3 lolly, 4 lolly, okay? So I'm going to count this. First, I'm going to count the rhythm. So 6/4 time, there's two beats in the measure, two beats in each measure. And what gets the beat in 6/4 time? What gets the beat? Well, three of those combined. So it's the beat, two beats, and the beat is a dotted quarter note, dotted half note, excuse me. All right, so one lolly. Remember, we're going to 6/8 time. 6/8 time, the bottom note tells me, oh, it takes three of those to make a beat. And there's two beats in every measure. It takes three of those to make a beat. And there's two beats in every measure. So I'd count this one, la, li, two. The la is right in here someplace. And there's li. I notice a lot of people putting the li right on the second pulse of the beat, the second pulse of the beat. But it's not. La comes right after two. If you have three, the three parts of the beat, then the next part of the beat, the next of the third, of those three pulses, the next one is la, and that's li. Now, we've got it over here to one again, because we're coming to the next measure, parentheses, because there's a tie. Nothing's happening. We're going to count that, but that's la right there. That's one, li, two. So this would be li, because there is all the beat. There's all beat one. Here's all the beat two, so that would be beat two. There's where la is, and then li is right here. And so then the last measure is actually two beats. One, two, two. All right, now let's transcribe this in the 6/8 time. All right, so what is one lolly like in 6/8? One lolly, well, it's three eighth notes, right? All right, so we're going to start on this E. Three eighth notes, E, F sharp, G sharp, and that would be a quarter note, eighth note. So there's one la li, two li, it's tied over. Since these are all eighth notes, you could do this. This would be acceptable, is to connect them like that. It's also you can do with it something like that. Since this is all the beat and this is all the beat, this is more way more modern way of doing it. But if you do the flags, that's actually a more traditional way of doing it. Okay. All right, we're going to, on page two, we're going to identify the number of intervals between the notes. Quality and number. Here's an example, D flat to E, D flat to E. D flat to E flat would be a major second. This is D flat to E natural, so it's an augmented second. This is a D flat to A. Well, D flat to A flat would be, what kind of interval? D flat to A flat would be a perfect fifth, some kind of five. But D flat to A natural would be an augmented fifth because it's a half step higher. All right, this would be F to A, F to A, some kind of third. F to A, well, A is the third note in the key of F. It's a major third. All right, what is this right here? The notes are C to F. In the key of C, F is the fourth note in the scale. So this would make it a perfect fourth. C to G flat. C to G flat. C. What's a perfect fifth from C? Be a G, right? C to G is a perfect fifth. So C to G flat would be a diminished fifth. Now this is kind of bizarro here. It looks bizarro. G flat to A sharp. All right. G flat to A sharp. All right. Well, G flat to A flat. Oh my goodness. G flat to A flat would be a major second. G flat to A natural would be an augmented second. This is a double augmented second. Don't worry, that won't be on the exam. Probably a typo. I don't think I'll ever see a double. I think I probably have seen a couple, but G sharp to A sharp. Let's get back into reality, people. G sharp to A sharp? What is that? If you said major second, you would be correct. G sharp to E sharp. Well, first of all, what's the number? Let's see, 1, 3, 5, 6. It's some kind of six. Now, well, they both have sharps, so this would be easy. Take both sharps away. You take both sharps away, it's G to E. What's G to E? G to E, in key of G, what's an E? A six, okay, well, that'd be, E is the second. In key of G to E is a major six. So, G sharp to E sharp is also a major six. D flat to F, well, in the key of D flat, F is B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, it is F. Now, let's look at this one. That is a B to F, B to F. Some kind of fifth, right? 1, 3, 5, yeah, some kind of fifth. What's a perfect fifth from B? Accidentals agree, unless there was an F and a B. Ooh, all right, B to F. In the key of B, what's a perfect fifth? Well, B to F sharp is a perfect fifth. But this is B to F natural, so that makes it a diminished fifth. All right, this is B to C. What's B to C? Well, in the key of B, F sharp, C sharp, oh. A major second would be B to C sharp, so this is a minor second, B to C. It's a half step. It's a half step, two different pitches, two different note names. Now, this is a C to an A, so 1, 3, 5, 6, some kind of six. In key of C, what's a major sixth? Well, there's no sharps and flats in key of C, so C to A is a major sixth. All right, B to A, B to A. So the number, let's do the number first. 1, 3, 5, 7, it's some kind of seventh. In the key of B, what's a major seventh? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. Oh, so B to A sharp is major. So this is B to E. B to E, in the key of B, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, B, F sharp, oh, just E. B to E is a perfect fourth. All right, what's E to G? E to G. Well, some kind of third. And the key of E was a major third. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D, oh, G sharp. But this is E to G, so that makes it a minor third. All right, G to C. In the key of G, what is C? Well, let's first look at the number. One, two, three, four. Four, so some kind of fourth. G to C is a perfect fourth. All right, hope that helped. Let's go to the next one. Now, this will be on the exam. It's where you have to figure out the missing information. So here's an example. All right. So in the key of E flat, F, that's not right. That's really funny. That's not right. In the key of F, in the key of E flat, F is the supertonic. Key of F's. And the key of E flat, F is a supertonic. Well, I got there. Okay, so in the key of D, F sharp and C sharp, what's the subdominant? In the key of D, what's the subdominant? The subdominant is the which scale degree? It is the scale degree number. Subdominant is the fourth. So in the key of D, what's the fourth pitch? What's the subdominant in the key of D? G. Now we're in the key of, what's that key? One flat. Key of F. So a G, we're in the treble clef. In G, G is what scale degree? It is the supertonic. There you go. We just did it. We did something like it. All right. Now, F sharp is a submediant. Okay, so if F sharp's the submediant, which is which degree, which scale degree number? Submediant. It's a sixth. So that's the sixth note. So let's go up here. So the tonic would be that note. Tonic and the leading tone and then the submediant. All right, so the submediant's the sixth degrees. So the tonic would be this note right here, A. So is that right? Is it A or A flat? Well, it's got a sharp in it, so I'm looking. F sharp, C, oh, F sharp. So, in the key of A major, A, B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, A. So, we're in the key of A. So, over here, you in treble clef, you put F sharp, C sharp, G sharp. Okay, that's the answer. All right, let's look at this one. We're in the key of E. And there's a D sharp. So what is D sharp? What's the scale degree name for D sharp in the key of E? It'd be the seventh, so that would be the leading tone. Capital L, ding, lowercase t, o, n, e. That's the leading tone. It's the last note of the E major scale. E, F sharp, G sharp, A, B, C sharp, D sharp. That's T. And then do is E. All right, so we're given, and this is an F, just F, it's an F natural. All right, there's no key signature given, F, and it's the mediant. So it tells me that's the third note of the scale. That's the third note of the scale. So let's go down three and see what it looks like. So, all right, is F the third note in the key of D? No, F sharp's the third note. In the key of D. So this, let's try it with D flat. In D flat, is F third note? B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat. Yeah, it is. F's just F. It's the third note of the scale. So D flat. So I go here and I go B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat. One more. G flat. Key of D flat. That's the answer. In the key of D flat, F is the mediant. I don't need to put that there. That's just for me figuring it out. All right, let's look at this one. Okay, they want us to write the submediant note in the key of B flat. That's the key of B flat, two flats, B flat and E flat. So what's the submediant? It's the sixth note of the scale. So I know I'm in B flat, and this is bass clef, so I know the key is B flat. So what's the, go down eight, seven, six. So it's going to be a G something. All right, well, is it G or G flat or... Well, it's G. There's a key signature. So in the key of B flat, G is the sixth note. B flat, C, D, E flat, F, G. Okay. And now we're still in bass clef. We have an F sharp, and it's the leading tone. So what's the key? If F sharp is the leading tone, well, we know the leading tone is a half step down from the tonic. So F sharp up a half step is G. So the key here is G major. And bass clef, so I put the F sharp right here. That's the key of it. It doesn't even really need that. We had to put it there because we didn't tell you what the key was. All right. I say we, speaking for myself, plurally. Yes, I have many personalities. This is one, and I seem so calm at the moment. All right, we have the key signature of three flats, which is what? One. B flat, E flat. There's the key. There's the name of the key. There's the Do. There's Do right there. E flat. So we're in the key of E flat. So in the key of E flat, what's that pitch called? What's that scale degree name? Well, there's the tonic, supertonic, the mediate, the subdominant. So this is sub. Keep it lowercase. Dominant. Hopefully your handwriting is better than mine. All right. And now in this key, which is what key is this? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. Key of B, five sharps. We need to write the leading tone note in the key of B. Well, you can write it here, or you can write it up here, either way. A sharp is a leading tone. In the key of B, A sharp is the leading tone. There it is. And the last one, this is the dominant. We're in bass clef. So that's the dominant. That's an F. So what's the tonic? What's the name of the key signature? Well, let's go down five. One, that's five, three, one. So it's going to be a B something. Key of B, what's the perfect fifth of B? B, F sharp. Oh, but this is F natural. So, oh, okay. So it's going to be B flat. B flat and E flat. Because in the key of B flat, now let's check it. In the key of B flat and E flat. Okay, well, it's F. Yeah, what number is B flat, C, D, E, E flat, F? You're right, B flat to F is a perfect fifth. That's the dominant. Perfect fifths, the fifth of the scale is the dominant. So, for the tonic to the dominant is a perfect fifth. All right. Let's move down here. Last but not least. Do not write the key signature. Add the correct notes with accidentals to each scale without the key signature. Okay, so ooh, I have to fill in the missing notes. So here's D flat. We're in the key of D flat. So first of all, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'm missing that one, that one, and that one. All right. So D flat, E. I'm going to go ahead and write them in. F G A. B flat C. All right, so now put in the key signature. Always do it in the order they appear in the key signature. So we start B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, and then one more, G flat. There's the answer. Five flats, D flat's five flats. All right, now A. Well, first let's put in all of our notes. Okay, there's A. And there's B, and I need a C. Get all my eighth note to E, F, something. And then the A is right there. We'll just put it around the end here, okay? Now I have my eight notes, my octave. Now let's go through the key signature. Well, there's an F sharp. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp. That's it. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp. And there's the answer. All right, let's do this one. The key of Edward. The key of everything. All right, one. I need an F. I have the G. Sorry, G sharp. A, the B, and the C. Yeah, okay. I'll put little stems on them. Go up an octave. All right, now the key signature for E is how many sharps? It's four sharps, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp. All right, so F sharp, C sharp, oh, wrong one. F sharp. Where is that? Oh, here it is. F sharp, C sharp. So I'll put my F sharp here. And there's C sharp. G sharp. And then D sharp. Oh, it's right there. So that's all I needed to do. F sharp, C sharp. All right. How about this one? You got this one figured out yet? Well, let's add our. I mean, there's, I got A, I need a G, and then a B, and there's a C. D, and there's an E. And there's an F. And there's my G. All right. Now let's go through the accidentals. All right, start on B flat, B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, and then one more C flat. B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, one more C flat. And there's the answer. All right, so this is base. This is not basic. This is exact same thing we're going to have on exam number 3. Won't be as many things. I mean, you'll have like 3 of these and 3 of these, and you'll probably have that many. I'll probably have 4, and this will be pretty much just like that. All right. So this is very much the exam is going to be super similar to what we've done on this practice exam. On the actual exam, you'll have this many, probably. You're gonna probably, I think they're all dotted half notes. I don't have them like this. They all dotted half notes. For some reason, I put them in dotted half notes. This is gonna be exactly like on the exam. What we did here. You have to know your key signature and the scale degree names. Which number they belong to, you know. And we're going to have at least 2 of these, just like this, all right? So I think it's a good heads up for you, all right? Oh, look, that's pretty ugly right there. So I hope you do well! Exclamation point.